Good day. My name is Ugochukwu Ukwebu. I am a cloud engineer. In this tutorial, I will clone the code of a pre-built website from GitHub into an Elastic Compute Cloud instance and serve the website files over the internet. This tutorial is the second of a four-part series of videos where I showed how to deploy dynamic applications on AWS Cloud. Prerequisite to this tutorial is a previous tutorial I did on how to set up an Amazon EC2 instance and install LAMP Stack on Amazon Linux 2023. You'll find the link to that tutorial in the comment section below. So let me get right on with my presentation. The first place to begin is to log into your AWS Cloud Console. This is my console home, and the service we'll be using is EC2. We can search for it. EC2 is it's there. I could have clicked there, but just in case, we go to EC2 and click on Instances. All right, so we have some instances. One of them is the instance we used in tutorial one. So after tutorial one, I stopped it. It's a technique we use to save on cost, but I'm back on. I'm ready to use it again. So I'm starting the machine. So in that first tutorial, we set up this virtual server, Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud EC2 instance. We installed LAMP Stack on the instance, LAMP being Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. And on the MariaDB database there, we populated the database with data and wrote a web page script to retrieve data and display it on a web page, which we accessed over the internet. So I click on that instance and I want to connect to it. I want to get remote access to it. If you go through tutorial one, we'll say that there are several ways to connect to gain access to that machine. I want to gain access to it and install the website code in that machine and serve it over the internet. So the option we use is SSH Cloud. The one I used in that tutorial one is SSH clients. And these are the steps. Open an SSH client, relocate your private key, my own private key. That's my private key that I downloaded. And because this is more like the key that will give me access to that machine. Without this key pair, I can't connect remotely to that machine, which is hosted in Stockholm. That's in Europe, right? AWS groups resources according to regions. So I've located that to connect to that machine. The command, there's a command there that's already given to us, pre-built. So I copy that command. I go back to this where my private key is, and I will open an SSH client. I'm comfortable using Git Bash, so I have Git Bash. So I paste that command there. Okay, first of all, let's see that we have our key. I do an ls to show that key pair there. So I paste that command there. All right. If that key pair was not there, I won't be able to get access to that machine, and I click yes. Yes, I want to continue connecting. So I'm into that machine, and yes, that's it. Tells us where the machine is, and we have access to it. So if I do an ls, right, it shows an empty. Well, it appears to be an empty directory there, but we've already installed LAMP there. So let me go to the document root of Apache server. The command to do that is cd slash var slash www dot slash html. That's document root for website files. And if we do an ls, we can see my sample data.php that we created in tutorial one. So I'm in this machine. What I want to do, I want to get the code for that I want to deploy in that machine. It's on this GitHub handle. My GitHub handle is a website code I deployed and put up there. So the code, the readme says demo website for a computer shop. This is the demo website for a retail shop. In this case, a computer shop. It was built using HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and some PHP code to process the contact form. This code can be downloaded and used by anyone cutting their teeth in website design. Feel free to modify it and make it your own. A functional version of this demo website can be found or can be seen at that URL there. Cheers. So that's a readme. We have an idea of what that code does. So we copy that and go back to our terminal. The command to do that is git clone, and I paste that command there. Okay, tells us that git command not found, so we've not installed git on this machine, and the command to do that is sudo yum install git, then to say yes. All right, so we've installed git. So let me run that command I ran the first time. So we have git tool then now. And so if I do an ls, we can see that I already have my computer shop code directly there. So if I cd into that computer shop that's in, I think, is it purple or blue? If I cd into that directory, we can see website files. It's a readme and a couple of files and a folder and an images folder. So that's not the document root directory of Apache web server. So I want to move all those files to the document root, and the command to do that is sudo, as a command, Linux command, move all to the upper directory. So if I do an ls, I'll see all my files have been moved. So let me go back to the document root and I do an ls, right? You can see it moved all those files to this directory, right? So we've got all those and we have our index.php there. So let's see, let's go test if we're going to find, or at least let's access this over the internet, right? We've set up our server, installed codes there. So let's go online and check it out. So I click back here. What I need to do that is I need a public IP address for that. So if I come here and I paste that, and I think the name of that was index.php. And yep, we have the code of our full stack website on our EC2 machine, which is a server right now. So that's it, right? This contact page, we still need to do some configurations on that server to be able to process this contact page. But we've achieved what we set out to do, set up the code and put it there. So this is it, right? Full stack website. If you want to look at that machine, the first code that we ran the first time, that's my sample data.php. You want to see that it's still there. Let's put that my sample data.php, right? So yeah, this is what we call a dynamic application. Dynamic meaning that there's a database and then there's a script. The script logs into the database, gets data and displays it online, right? So this data is dynamic. It's fetching it from a database, right? So our server is up and running. It's set up and I've just demonstrated how you can set up an EC2 machine instance. It's pretty, I think it's on a free tier, right? And this machine can do a lot of things there. So if you're a full stack developer, this makes a lot of sense to you. So you have a sense of you now know what it takes to deploy your code, your full stack code, into the cloud, right? You know, at least into an elastic cloud compute on AWS. So that brings this tutorial to an end. Like I said, it's the second in a four-part series. In this same server, I'm going to install and configure a WordPress application. Then in the fourth one, I'm going to install and secure phpMyAdmin on this EC2 instance, right? And this hands-on tutorials gives you the basis to build dynamic websites, backends for web applications, backends for mobile applications, and pretty much anything you can build using the LAMP stack, right? And if you find this video useful, do like and share. If you have questions or comments, drop them below and I'm going to respond to you. So thank you very much. Finally, or once again, my name is Uguchukwu Ukwebu, and I wish you a happy cloud experience. Thank you very much.